said, no more monkeys jumping on the bed.
That's a good one. Oh, hi, welcome to Sesame Street. I'm sure glad you're here because all the kids and Telly and Placido Flamingo and I were just about to play the Eensy Weensy Spider. You might know it. Okay, now, this is the way it's gonna go, okay? I will sing the Eensy Weensy Spider and you'll all do the hand movements that go with it, okay? Can you do that? It's like, it's pretty soft. Yeah, right. Excuse me. Yes, Placido, what is it?
Well, excuse me, my little friend, but I'm afraid that I did not hear you correctly. Yes, I thought I heard you say that you were going to sing.
No, you heard me correctly. That's what I said. I am going to sing the Eensy Weensy Spider, and all the kids...
You are going to sing when the great one, I, Placido Flamingo, the greatest singer of singers, is here?
Well, it's just a short little song, Placido, and if you'd like, you're more than welcome to sing along with me.
Oh, this song about the spider, is it opera?
Opera? No, it's not opera, no.
Oh, well, I, Placido, the great one, does not know songs that are not from operas.
Well, then, Placido, maybe you'd just like to watch and listen and then join us later, okay? Okay, now, is everybody ready? You know, it starts like this, okay? Are you ready? Okay, I'll sing it, and you make all the hands go, okay? Ready? Okay, you ready? The Eensy Weensy Spider crawled up the water spout. Down came the rain and washed the spider out. Out came the sun and dried up all the rain. And the Eensy Weensy Spider crawled up the spout again. That was terrific. Give yourselves a hand. Oh, let's do it again, all right? That was so good. And this time, you can do it with us, okay? All right, here we go. Get ready. Eensy Weensy Spider climbed up the water spout. Down came the rain and washed the spider out. Out came the sun and dried up all the rain. And the Eensy Weensy Spider crawled up the spout again. That was wonderful. That's very good. Oh, and Placido, thank you very much for your patience, okay? You see, it was just a quick, simple little song.
Yes, it was nothing.
Well, I wouldn't say that.
Well, I mean it was nothing compared to the great world-famous opera that I, Placido, the great one, has sung at the Metropolitan.
What opera is that?
Only one of the most famous operas of all time, The Spider's Feelings.
The Spider's Feelings?
Exactly. It is one of the great operas of the world.
Well, I don't know, but I bet we'd all love to see it, huh?
What a fantastic idea!
What idea?
Why, your idea, my friend. Everyone can see the spider's feelings. Here, now, today, soon, an opera right in this very place. I, Placido Flamingo, the great one, will sing the role of narrator. That's the one who tells the story.
You will?
I will. And you, my little purple friend, will perform in the opera with me.
I will?
You will. You will play the role of the cloud.
The cloud? Gee,
You, my friend, will also be in the opera, playing the role of the sun.
Why, thank you.
And you, my little singer of songs, will also be in the opera.
Oh, not me, Placido.
Oh, but you must. It is most important.
No, thank you. No.
Oh, but it is the lead.
The lead?
The lead. You will be the star.
The star?
See, so will you sing in the opera?
Well, yes, of course. Yes, I would love to.
Good, you play the spider. Now.
The spider? What? Wait a minute. Not the spider. I've changed my mind. Forget it, Placido.
Oh, but you cannot. You gave your word that you would sing in my opera, and you cannot break a promise.
Oh, no, please.
So everyone hurry. We must get costumes. No. We must build the set. I must call my hangers-on to perform in the chorus. Oh, and before you know it, we will all be back to perform for you the greatest of operas, The Spider's Feelings Opera. I love it.
The story of Nancy the Nanny Goat is brought to you by the letter N. Nancy the Nanny Goat lived north of Nantucket. Nancy had a pet, a nice nightingale.
I am a nightingale.
Now, Nancy was a nincompoop because around her neck she wore a narrow napkin. One night in November at 9:09, she got a notion to visit a nutty nanny goat farm. Numbskull, nitwit, nincompoop were some of the nasty names the other nanny goats called her as she sat nibbling on her nails. The granny nanny goat noticed Nancy and said,
Nancy, don't be a ninny. Never nibble on your nails.
Nancy became nervous. She took off the narrow napkin and put on a nifty necklace. Instead of nibbling her nails, she started to notice noodles. Granny nanny goat noticed Nancy and said,
Nanny goats who nibble on their nails and notice noodles are nutty.
This story of Nancy the Nanny Goat was brought to you by the letter N.
To imagine things. Imagine that I'm a great big rock sitting on top of a mountain for years and years and years. And one day, there's an earthquake, and I roll down the mountain and fall right into the sea. I sit there for years and years and years until all sorts of seaweed and moss and gooky stuff grows all over me. Then one day, I'm washed up onto the beach, and a man sees me. And being an artist, the man decides to make me into a statue. He chisels and chips away for a very long time, and when his statue is finished, it's put on a pedestal in the middle of town. And do you know what that statue is? It's a statue of me. And that's what would happen if I were a rock. I like to imagine things.
Hey, Ernie.
Hi, Bert.
Hey, Ernie. I think it's about time that you put away these toys.
Oh, well, Bert, I didn't bring all these toys out here. You brought some of these toys out here.
Well, yeah, but you brought most of the toys out here.
Okay, Bert. Well, I tell you what, I'll put most of the toys away, okay?
Okay. Okay, and I'll pick up the rest later, okay?
Okay, fine, Bert.
Good. Bye-bye. Mm-hmm.
Let's see. If I could just group these toys into groups, and I'll put away a group of toys. How about that? Tell you what, I'll put away all the fire engines. Now, here's one fire engine here. See, are there any other fire engines here? Don't see any other. No other fire engines. Okay. So I'll put away the fire engine. Oh, but there's still an awful lot of toys left there. I guess I better put away one more group of toys. Tell you what, I'll put away all the big toys. All the big toys. See, it's not a very big toy. No. I don't see any other big toys. So here's a big toy. Look at this big toy here. I'll put away the fire engine. Well, there's still a lot of toys there. I think I better put away another group of toys. I'll put away all the red toys. How about that? All the toys that are red. That toy's kind of pinkish, but it's certainly not red. You're not red, are you? No. Red toys. Any red toys? Here's a red toy. Look at that. The fire engine. Okay, I'll put away the fire engine. Oh, but there's still a lot of toys there. I better put away one more group of toys. I'll put away all the toys with wheels. How about that? All the toys with wheels. Rubber Ducky, do you have wheels? Nope, he doesn't have wheels. Horse have wheels? Oh, horse doesn't have wheels. Hey, here's a toy with wheels. The fire engine. Look at the wheels. Everybody see the wheels on the fire engine? Yep, there are the wheels right there. Okay, I'll put away the fire engine. Still too many toys here. I better put away one more group of toys. Put away all the toys with ladders. How about that? All the toys with ladders. Any ladders on the trombone? Nope. No ladders. Here's a toy with ladders. The fire engine. Okay, I'll put away the fire engine. I'm certainly putting away a lot of toys.
Hey, Ernie? Ernie?
Yes, Bert?
Hey, Ernie.
What?
Hey, I thought you were going to put most of the toys away.
Oh, I'm just about to, Bert.
Yeah?
I'll tell you what. I'll tell you which toys I'm going to put away, all right?
Okay.
Now, I'm going to put away all the fire engines.
Good.
And all the big toys.
Yeah.
And all the red toys.
Yeah.
And all the toys with wheels. And all the toys with ladders. Okay, Bert?
Yeah.
Okay.
Uno, dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, seis, siete, ocho, nueve.
Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you with pride the greatest of operas, The Spider's Feelings. Maestro?
There was a spider. He was incy and wincy. He had many feelings. I'll tell you about him, now. A happy spider all day long, he'd climb up the water spout and sing a song. He'd climb up high and sing out loud,
I'm an incy wincy spider and I feel so proud.
A happy spider all day long would climb up the water spout and sing a song. He'd climb up high and sing out loud,
I'm an incy wincy spider and I feel so proud.
Proud little spider, he was incy and wincy. It hurts to explain, a cloud came and made it rain.
Oh, Mr. Flamingo, do I really have to?
But of course, it is the opera.
I mean, I know I'm the cloud, and then the clouds make it rain, but...
A cloud came and made it rain, 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 rain.
Oh, well.
He's so unhappy, he's feeling sad. Poor incy spider, he feels so bad. Poor spider, what can he do? It make Fluffy Doe to cry boo. Boo.
Weensy Spider don't have sad feelings. The sun, she is here.
The sun will shine upon you, Incy Wincy Spider, do not complain. The pretty sun will keep smiling on you, and the sun will dry all the rain. The sun will dry all your arms off, it will dry your face, dry your hair and more. My Incy Spider, you will soon be climbing up that spout just as before.
Go ahead and try to climb again. Go ahead, you can do it.
You can do it. You can do it. Incy Spider, Incy Spider, climb up and down. You can do it. Nothing to it. Incy Spider, Incy Spider, jump for the ball now.
Yay!
Incy Wincy,
he's so full of joy.
He's so happy, hear him singing.
I'm the lucky boy.
Incy Wincy, give that spider a hug.
He's so happy, hear him singing.
I'm a lucky bug.
Nice little spider. He's so incy and wincy. Now he's so happy, and now our story is
done.
It's done, it's done, 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 done. Our story's
done.
It's done. Our story's done. Done.
Excellent, excellent, especially you, Senor Spider.
Thank you very much, Mr. Flamingo, but now, if you don't mind, can I get out of this costume? I feel a little silly.
Change out of the costume? Oh, but no.
No?
You have performed so wonderfully as the spider, the audience must have an encore.
An encore? You mean another song?
Oh, yes, por favor. Stay in that costume. I will get your partner for your encore.
My partner? Well, yes, but please hurry, all right?
I'll be right back.
I hope no one sees me in this outfit.
Come in.
Hello there.
Where?
Right here. Is this the Gerfner Employment Agency?
So is this.
Well, I want a job.
What can you do?
I can write.
You can?
G? Certainly. G happens to be one of my best letters.
Well, I don't think...
As a matter of fact, many wonderful words begin with G. You can tell by the G sound.
Good.
Well, that's one of them. Good. And girl, and garden, and gas, grape, goat, goose, gum, and,
Gorilla.
Where?
Right here. You're a gorilla.
I am. G.
That's right. Gorilla also begins with the letter G. And you are definitely a gorilla.
Gosh, in that case, I'd better get out of here.
Where are you going?
Well, I have to go learn how to run around in the jungle and eat bananas.
Was a rooster who thought he had nothing to crow about. He couldn't give milk, he couldn't give wool, and he was far too small to be much good pulling a wagon or giving rides. Now it happened that he lived on a farm that couldn't get up in the morning. One day, the farmer went out to see if something couldn't be done. And he asked the little rooster if he wouldn't like to help get everyone up in the morning. Now, the rooster thought he'd like to help, but he didn't see what in the world he could do. Never mind, the farmer said. You just do whatever you do best. At the break of day, the next morning, the whole farm slept, except the little rooster, who got up early to do his best to wake up the farm. He took a deep breath, and then he said... And everybody woke up. Now you see him strut around. No one was ever so loud, or quite so proud.
Good evening, and welcome to Monsterpiece Theater. Me, your host, Alistair Cookie. Tonight, Monsterpiece Theater proud to present classic play, The Taming of the Shrew, by William Shakespeare, famous podiatrist. Trust me. And now, The Taming of the Shrew.
Oh, shoo, shoo, wherefore art thou shoo? Oh, there you are. Methinks I will put you on and walk to the Padua Mall.
Unhand me, Grovero.
Oh, what a shoe you are. I, Grovero, only want to put you on my foot and tie up your laces, you see? Just like my other shoe.
Fie! I will not be tied to any foot.
But shoe, I cannot walk to the Padua Mall with only one shoe. 'Twould be embarrassing.
Find yourself another shoe. I walk alone.
Oh, fine. Go ahead, you shoe. See how forest you can get without a foot.
Drat. Methinks this is harder than me thought.
I told you so, Shoe. Please, can we not cooperate?
Cooperate?
Yes. You needeth a foot, and I needeth a shoe. Let us walk together.
All right, but watch your step.
Fine, I shall be very, very careful. There. Aha, gadzooks. I have tamed the shoe.
Yeah.
Aha, there now, Shoe. Is it not better when we cooperate? And now we can walk to the mall.
Forget it. I don't want to walk to the mall.
But Shoe, I thought you were going to cooperate.
I want to dance to the mall.
Dance? Okay-eth. We can cooperate and danceth to the mall. Hitteth it!
So goes the course of shoe love. This is Alistair Cookie of Monsterpiece Theater saying, to thine own self, be shoe. Ah, nom, 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 nom.
Meow, 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 meow
It's time for Placido's encore with the spider and his partner. And it goes like this. Oh, who are the bugs in your neighborhood? In your neighborhood, in your neighborhood. Oh, who are the bugs in your neighborhood? The bugs that you meet each day. Hey there, fellow. I'll bet Placido knows who you are. You are a bee.
Right. Hey, did you hear about the fellow who was allergic to bees?
Allergic to bees?
Uh-huh. Bees always gave him hives. Get it? If you ask me what a bumblebee does, I will tell you that you'll buzz and buzz. A bee makes honey taste so sweet for an extra special eating treat.
All the bumblebees are bugging your neighborhood. In your neighborhood, in your neighborhood. Yes, the bumblebees are bugging your neighborhood. A bug that you meet each day.
Ah, look there, another bug, a spider.
Yes, I am a little spider. And do you know why a spider is like a baseball player?
No, why is a spider like a baseball player?
Because they're always both trying to catch a fly. Oh, a spider walks along the street with all his many legs and feet. He'll spin a web most every day and scare Miss Muffet right away.
Oh, the spider is a bug in your neighborhood.
In your neighborhood. In your neighborhood.
And the bumblebee's a bug in your neighborhood.
They're the bugs that you meet
when you're walking down the street.
They're the bugs that you meet each day.
Now I can finally get out. I can finally get out of this silly costume.
Oh, see, and you did an excellent job.
Thank you.
The Great Inventor Series, stories of men and women whose contributions have changed our lives.
Once, a very long time ago, if people got hungry while they were playing with their friends, they'd go get some meat, they'd go get some cheese, they'd go get some bread, and they'd pick up a pickle, and some knives, and some forks, and some spoons. By the time they were ready to eat, there wasn't time, and there wasn't room to play games anymore. You just couldn't eat and play with your friends. It was John Montague, the Earl of Sandwich, who decided to do something about this predicament. He tried serving meat, just meat. No knives, no forks, not a pickle. But his friends, he noticed, got grouchy and greasy. What a pickle! Suddenly a thought hit him. If I take two pieces of bread and put the meat and the cheese and the pickle between them, I could play with my friends and eat with my friends.
The sandwich was born. John, the Earl of Sandwich, and his invention are known today the world over. Science salutes the Earl of Sandwich.
I like to make up stories, but my favorite thing to write about is something that really happened to me. First, I draw the pictures. I like to use markers because their colors are really bright. Then I write the words underneath. Sometimes I ask my mom how to spell a word.
Mom, how do you spell ingredients?
I-N-G-R-E-D-I-E-N-T-S.
You can staple the pages together or something simple like that, but I like to make a hard cover. I use cardboard and I glue fabric over it. Then I sew the pages in. When the book is done, it looks really nice. It was my mother's birthday. My dad took my mom out for the day to a museum. My brother and I wanted to make my mom's birthday very special.
See you in a couple of hours, guys.
So we planned a surprise.
we went out and shopped for presents. We ended up getting headphones for our tape recorder. And we got some flowers too. Then we went shopping for some ingredients for a cake. Took a long time to make. When we were done, the sink was filled with dishes. Then we cleaned up and wrapped the presents. We all had a nice time eating the cake and opening the presents. Everything turned out perfect.
Hi there, Elmo.
How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Yes, listen, I'm so happy to see you, because now Elmo can help Kermit do something. Yay!
Well, Elmo, I don't need any help right now. Thank you very much. Anyhow, okay?
But Kermit! Kermit! Hmm? Kermit, you know how you always say, hi-ho, Kermit the Frog here. Mm-hmm. And today, you know how you do that?
Yeah.
Well, maybe Elmo can help Kermit with that.
I'm not doing anything like that right now, Elmo. I'm just taking these packages to the post office and mail them, and I'm kind of in a hurry, okay?
Please, Elmo, help Kermit.
I don't need any help. I just have to mail these packages very quickly now, okay, Elmo?
Well, there must be something that Elmo can do for Kermit.
Elmo, there's something that we can demonstrate together.
Oh, good. What's that?
Closed, Elmo.
Closed?
Mm-hmm.
Well, what's that?
You see the sign back there on the post office?
Oh, uh-huh.
You see, that sign says closed, and we have demonstrated it, you and I, together, okay?
Well, we did, but how, Kermit?
Well, you see, while you were talking to me, they closed the post office, so now I can't mail my packages until tomorrow. Elmo, watch
you. Oh, you make a little monster very happy, Kermit. Mwah. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye, Elmo.
Un rectángulo. Es una puerta. Un rectángulo. Es un camión. Busca un rectángulo. Rectángulo.
Mm-hmm.
Here comes the herd from the Bar Double X. Let's count them up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Yep, it's the herd from the Double X Bar. Let's count them up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. I wonder how many head we got all together. For that matter, I wonder how many whole cows we got all together. There are 16 over there, and there are 14 over there. Together, that probably gives us, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. All right, let's move them out. Yeehaw! Say, that can't be the way to do it.
Boy, I certainly am glad to get out of that spider costume and back into my own clothes. Hi, Telly.
Hi, Bob. Oh, no! Oh, Bob! Bob, this is awful! Look, you took off your spider costume! You're back in your regular clothes! Oh, Bob, you've got to help me. Please, put the spider costume back on again, won't you, Bob? Won't
what?
You, please?
Telly, I just got out of it.
Oh, please, Bob, do me that favor just for a minute. Pretty, pretty, please. I need it for a science experiment. Yeah, please, just for a minute. One minute. Please, please.
All right, Telly, but just for a minute and just for you.
Oh, right? Thanks, Bob. Thank you so much.
Yeah, right.
Thank
right,
you.
Right.
I'll be waiting here. Whew. You see, I've always wanted to count the number of legs that a spider had. I'll be able to count them when Bob puts his costume back on. Wow. Wow. Look at this. I've never seen anything like this. It looks like a big, huge mushroom.
It's a tuffet, and it's mine.
Well, hi. It's yours, and it's a what?
A tuffet. I like to sit on it. Hello, I'm new in the neighborhood. My name's Annabelle. What's yours?
Oh, hi, Annabelle. I'm Telly.
Telly what? What's your last name?
My last name? My last name is Monster, Telly Monster.
Oh, my last name is Muffet, Annabelle Muffet.
Muffet. Your name is Muffet, and you're sitting on a tuffet?
Yeah, right. Will you excuse me if I eat my snack?
Muffet and Tuffet. Oh, boy. You know who I think this is? Did you ever hear the rhyme about how Little Miss Muffet sat on a tuffet eating,
Oh, I love these curds. Little bumps of cottage cheese. Yum.
Curds! She's eating curds!
Right, and some nice whey. Thinny, thin milk.
And whey, too. Little Miss Muffet sat on a tuffet eating her curds and whey. It's her! It's you, Little Miss Muffet!
That's my name!
Oh, boy! Hey, do you think you could stick around here for a while and maybe we can play?
Yeah, sure I will.
Yeah! Oh, that is so funny! Oh, Bob! You look so funny!
You know this guy?
Yeah! This is my friend Bob! He's dressed up like a spider!
A spider?
Along came a spider and sat down beside her and frightened Miss Muffet away.
Goose. The goose and the gander. went on a trip over the rolling seas. They paddled away for a year and a day till they got to the land of the G's. Goose.
My hair is black and red. My hair is yellow. My eyes are brown and green and blue. My name is Jack and Fred. My name's Amanda Sue. I'm called Queen of Doo. My name is you. I live in southern France. I'm from a Texas ranch. I come from Mecca and Peru. I live across the street in the mountains on the beach. I come from everywhere and my name is you.
And now, a small man with a saw. And here, a smaller man with a saw. And finally, the smallest man with his saw. Small, smaller, smallest. The small man will saw the log. And now, the smaller man will saw the log. And finally, the smallest man will saw the log. I'm sorry, power saws don't count.
Meh! Jick. Magic. Magic. Ah, magic. A la peanut butter sandwiches. Now that's what I call magic.
Oh. What's wrong?
Baseball diamond. Must find baseball diamond.
You gonna play baseball?
No, no. My mothership is there. Must go home. Can you tell me how to get to the baseball diamond?
Sure. You go to the end of the block, past the playground, and through the big trees. It's right there.
Look for trees, then playground?
No, listen again. Go to the end of the block, past the playground, through the trees.
End of playground, around block.
I can't get you to your mothership if you don't listen.
So hard, so many things to see. Please tell me again.
Go to the end of the block, past the playground, and through the big trees. It's right there.
End of block, past playground, through big trees. Ah!
So I told him how to get to his mother's ship.
Now, son, you imagined him.
No, he was right there.
I always wanted to know how many legs a spider has.
What?
Could I count the legs first and then you can go?
All right, Tilly, but would you hurry, please?
Oh, okay, Bob. If you get down on your hands and knees, I figured out a way how to count them. If you get down on your hands and knees and turn in a circle very slowly,
all right,
I'll be able to count your spider legs one by one.
Like this, Tilly?
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Tell me when you're ready.
Okay, here goes.
Ready?
Yep.
Okay.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 16. I'm gonna lose count, Bob.
Tilly!
What is it?
Tilly!
What? What?
I think you've already counted these legs. I think you didn't know where to stop. So you've counted them all over again.
Oh, wow. I think you're right, Bob. That sure is a problem. How can I know when to stop?
Well, I don't know. Let me give you a hint. If you could just make one of my legs different, then you could start with that one. And then when it came around again, you'd know where to stop.
Hmm. Make one of the legs different than
right.
the others?
Yeah, anyway.
Yeah, I think I see.
Just
Bob,
hurry up.
Yeah, oh, hold on to this. This is my handkerchief.
Okay.
Yeah, if you hold on to that.
All right, so you want to start with this one?
Yes, I'll start with that one.
Okay, here we go again. Ready?
Okay.
That's one.
One. Two. Three. Four. Keep moving, Bob.
Okay.
Four. Five.
Right.
Six.
Yep.
Six. Keep moving, Bob.
Okay.
Seven.
Okay.
Eight.
Right.
And that's the one that I counted first, right?
Right.
So the answer is eight. A spider has eight legs.
That's it, Tilly. Terrific. You did it. That's good, Tilly. Now, can I please get out of this costume?
Well, sure, Bob. Go ahead.
Okay. Thanks.
Thank you.
I'm locked out.
End.
Gee, I'm thirsty, Bert. Bert? Oh, I forgot. Bert's away. He's visiting his brother, Bart. Boy. Usually when I wake up thirsty, I always tell Bert. Wish I could tell him that I was thirsty. Let's see. Maybe I could write him a letter. That would take about 3 days. Then he'd write a letter, and that would take another 3 days. By that time, I'd be awfully thirsty. Maybe I could just be patient and wait for Bert to come back. That'd take about 2 weeks. In 2 weeks, I'd be really thirsty. Wish I could just tell Bert. Wait a minute. I can tell Bert. Tell him on the telephone. Hello? Hello, Bert? Hey, Bert, it's Ernie. No, nothing's wrong. Listen, Bert, I was just thirsty, and I thought I would, I thought I would tell you, because I always tell you when I'm thirsty, Bert. No, Bert, I don't have any idea what time it is. Well, I was asleep too, Bert, until I woke up thirsty. Oh, right. Okay, Bert. Thanks a lot, Bert. Bert said to go get a drink of water and go back to sleep. That's what Bert always says. Well, certainly feels better. It's nice to know that Bert's just a phone call away. Gee. No, I can't sleep. Can't sleep, Bert. Hello, Bert. Hey, Bert, it's Ernie again. Hey, yes, thank you. I got the drink of water, but listen, Bert, now I can't sleep. Count sheep. Oh, great, Bert. That's wonderful, Bert. Okay, yeah. Oh, no. Don't worry. Listen, I won't call you anymore tonight. No. One sheep. Two sheep. What's that, Bert? No, I didn't forget to hang up the phone, Bert. No, it's three sheep. What do you mean, why you, Bert? Four sheep. Oh, this telephone is wonderful. It's almost like having Bert right here.
Ernie!
Five sheep.
Number 9. So here's a puzzle that's got 9 parts. Turn it into 9 red hearts. 9 bright ships go fluttering by. 9 birds flying in the sky. 9 houses down on
down the street, dancing to this funky beat. Nine windows open wide, nine people to look inside. Nine things if you hold back one. So here's nine ways and the song is done. That's nine things that nine can do. Now I'm done rapping, how about you? Nine.
This way? Okay. Oh, let's do Incy Wincy Spider one more time. Ready? Sing it.
Incy Wincy Spider climbed up the water spout. Down came the rain and washed the spider out. Out came the sun and dried up all the rain. And the Incy Wincy Spider climbed up the spout again.
Very good singing. Terrific.
Nice work. Catchy tune. I enjoyed that. Hey, do you know any others?
Maybe you've heard this one.
Yep. Sesame Street have been brought to you today by the letters G and N and by the number 9. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.